In the book of Joel, the people of Israel, they've been through this locust plague, and God had sent those bugs to eat their crops to show them how destitute their hearts had become. And that was just the beginning. Joel said that a way worse army was coming in the wake of the locusts who would destroy everything. So Joel commanded repentance in a very specific way, because when people were repenting or depressed, they would rip their shirts and put dirt on their heads. And Joel commanded internal repentance. He said, "Rend your hearts and not your garments." Rend means rip. Rip your heart, not your clothes. He's saying, want to return to me? Want to repent? Rip your heart in half, not your clothes. Joel is saying, don't do what looks like returning to God. Do what is returning to God. Then he says, return to the Lord your God, for he's gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and he relents over disaster. The people had sinned, the people had broken God's law, they'd given up on their promises with God, and Joel told them something beautiful and redemptive, that God would relent. He would stop. He would stop the approaching army. He would tell them to relent, to stop, to quit. He would stop the punishment from coming as a redemptive blessing for repentance. God is just. He will righteously judge the whole world, but he also relents. There's something beautiful here. God doesn't want to destroy everything and judge everything. He wants to be merciful. If you repent, he will relent. I know it rhymes and sounds cheesy, but it's true. A lot of times people describe the Old Testament God as mean and the New Testament God as loving, but they're the same God, and here we see both. What a great love that even with all of our sin and turning and running, God will relent. That's grace. And that is an awesome thing about God. Do you believe it?